recreation for the purpose of developing a stormwater management program that provides and informs the community about the need of the new Virginia regulations.
Madam Chair, just about that one, just a quick explanation. In their infinite wisdom, in 2011, the state took a program that they were managing and gave to local governments. And so they have given us this program. The purpose of this grant is to allow us to put together the bureaucracy, that's not a bad word, how to administer this program and how to put it in place. So it's the land disturbance of construction activity that was not currently covered under the city of Richmond ordinances, which used to be in DCR, which will now, as of July 1st of 2013, the department of the city of Richmond to operate and manage and control. So the purpose of this $25,000 is to help us set up that program. We expend these dollars between the time that you so choose to adopt it and then July 1st of this calendar year.
This
would be for disturbing new construction. This would basically be the big stuff that I'm happy to be there.
This is the amount that the state is going to be transferring for us to set it up since they're no longer going to be managing the program.
Correct.
Do you have an estimate of what this program is going to cost us? If this is a full allocation to cover that cost, or
This fee is just for the purposes of setting up the program. When we come to you during budgeting, we bring this program back to you again, and I will tell you what it costs. And the legislation from the state allows us to recover all the revenue from those people that get the permits. So this we're going to balance that out and show you that whatever the new revenue coming in equals what our new expenses are going to be going forward, because this will obviously continue to year after year. But as part of the process of regulating.
So this is simply to set up your overhead?
This is just simply to set up the departments. We have to make a lot of ordinance changes. We're going to have to make some changes structurally in how we issue permits. We have to go back in and make computer programming changes. It's more a organizational design grant than a start.
Any other questions? Anything there? All right, we're going to call the hearing. Anybody here to speak in favor or in opposition to this paper? Get back to committee. Thank you.
Second.
Okay. All those in favor?
Madam Chair, that paper will be forwarded with the recommendation to approve.
Great.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, let's go next to, let's go next to paper number three, the lease.
Okay. Item number 3-16-2013-1, and that's going to execute a lease between Attack Ventures, Inc. and from Kansas City for the purpose of providing a temporary site at East End Library at 3001 North Nine Road.
Good afternoon. I'm Harriet Colter, I'm Director of Richmond Public Library. And I would note first that Ms. Braxton has an amended version of this lease that you have in front of you. As you said, this is a request for a temporary site for the East End Library while it is under renovation. The lease was drafted by the City Attorney's Office, has been reviewed by the City Attorney's Office, and reviewed by Economic Development, and is supported by Councilmember Newbill. We are requesting specifically for the amended language and asking you to look at it today to act on that. We know that it would go back to be posted to Council again, publicly posted again at the January 28th meeting, acted on at your February 11 meeting. The amended version specifically adds its units C and D at 3001 Nine Mile Road, and then the amended language is item number 13 in the lease, section B, which essentially just expands the release and responsibility, the release language that's in 13A, that says that we will respond to any claims made against the tenant related to the tenant's use and occupation of the premises, but not including any claims made exclusively of or against the landlord. And as I said, this, the owner requested some expanded language and the city attorney's office drafted it.
I can't bother us looking, I do have one question, and that is, was this included in our budget this round?
We believe, yes, we have funds to cover this. The cost would be about $13,000 for the 6 months. That includes the rent, we'll pay electricity, we're installing a security system, we've got to do some cabling, and we'll have a security guard. Comcast is providing the internet access as a corporate contribution. So the total cost for the 6 months will be plus or minus $13,000.
Thanks. Any questions? Okay, thank you. Is there anyone to speak in favor or opposition to this favor? All right, seeing none, bring it back to council. Is there a motion to move to the floor?
To have this paper move forward to the full council.
With our approval.
With our approval.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
And all in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposition? Madam Clerk, bring move